Become a patron at www.patreon.com/GoldenEraBookworm for hard to find books, scans of rare photos, and articles on the golden era of bodybuilding. Hi everybody, Golden Era Bookworm here. Today's video is based on a great article I recently read written by the great Alan Stephan. Now I know I've presented several videos on Alan Stephan on the topic of arms development, and it is interesting to see how his biceps methods changed and became increasingly difficult and more advanced over time. The 1946 Mr. America was truly obsessed with his biceps development, as was evident in previous videos where I displayed several photos of his side chest pose, where his biceps development is so clear to see. Alan had these fantastic softball shaped biceps, as shown clearly in this single biceps pose. Now, why was Alan so obsessed with biceps development? Well, he states that the biceps can truly make or break a physique. He explains in the article how so many bodybuilders can simply change the look of their physique to being average to a more powerful championship winning physique by simply specializing on the biceps. And I believe this statement is very true, as the biceps has this transformative ability to a physique. He states it very clearly in the paragraph where he says, imagine a bodybuilder with powerful thighs, powerful chest, lats, broad shoulders, and skinny arms. I mean, now add some pretty decent biceps on there and now you've got a championship winning physique. So he's absolutely spot on there. Now the following bicep specialization program in this video is quite advanced, and Alan Stephan claims that it put a full 3/4 inch to his arms, bringing it to a full 19 inch measurement, which was very impressive for the silver era. This program is full of relatively advanced methods. And so there's a bit of a disclaimer there. Very, very advanced methods for only advanced trainees. And that's what I'm going to be detailing today. Now, one of the first concepts Alan Stephan talks about in this article is to use limit poundage. Basically, the principle of working towards single rep training. And he states that this should be ideally used with the barbell curl because it is a compound exercise and allows for heavy poundages to be used. And heavy poundage did he use? I mean, he wasn't cheating in the first stages of the program. He would start off with the strict curl and, believe it or not, warm up with 150 pounds. I mean, damn, that is some insane weight. And he would only do 4 or 5 reps, of course, in a very strict fashion. He would move up the weight to 180 pounds and then perform this for 2 or 3 reps. And then move on to single rep training. That was his full warm-up, by the way. That's pretty crazy. Then he would move on to single rep training, performing a single rep with 190 pounds, 205 and 215, which is incredible. Incredible amount of poundage just for barbell curls. It's crazy. And then he would do 1 or 2 single reps, if he had the energy, for performing cheat curls. And he would actually up the weight well above his single rep max, performing cheat curls with up to 240 pounds. It's pretty crazy. And I, the whole idea of this is limit poundage training or single rep training is to really start building the tendons and ligaments and the joint structure to be able to support larger biceps development. After taxing his tendons and ligaments, he would now move on to more of a hypertrophy style training for the biceps musculature, but with the principle of single arm training using the alternate dumbbell curl. And he liked training the alternate dumbbell curl in his more advanced program because this allowed him to have maximum concentration and apply maximum effort to the exercises shown here. He actually liked doing things standing because he's balancing himself with the other arm extended out to use maximum poundage, but with correct form. And he would only, as I said, perform sets with one arm at a time, starting off with a poundage that he could handle for at least 6 reps, and over time try and increase the reps to 12 to 15. And once he would reach this target rep range, he would then increase the weight. Now, a very interesting concept used by Alan Stephan here was to use the T-bar row movement to further develop his biceps, and he would actually perform heavy two-arm curls by adapting the T-bar row motion. He would load up a barbell and at one end, of course, with small plates. And this would allow him to actually have a greater range of motion, because of course if you load it up with large plates, you'll very quickly hit your chest. But by loading up with small plates and only bending at the elbows, he would have a greater range of motion. So he'd load up the barbell, wedge one end, the unloaded end of course, into the corner of a room, because back then they didn't have T-bar row stations, and grasping the bar with both hands, he would interlace the fingers and only move the arms at the elbows, and bringing the bar to the chest, he would be bending the elbows and flaring them outwards towards his sides. And this would basically be an adapted heavy two arm curl, and that's why he liked this motion, because he could really load up the barbell with heavier weight, and because he's using two arms, he could handle heavy poundage and work his arms from a different angle and get them much thicker, as he put it. This would add thickness, size, and strength to his biceps. A very interesting concept. The final exercise that Alan Stephan recommends in this advanced biceps specialization program is the use of what he calls an immovable concentration curl. Think of it nowadays as a single arm preacher concentration curl on the preacher bench. Back then, of course, I didn't have the preacher bench. And so he would sit down and place his resting arm, so his non-exercising arm, across both his knees. And placing his curling arm on the resting arm, this would actually fix his elbow. And therefore, only bending at the elbow, he would perform the concentration curl. So a very, very strict concentration curl. Of course, nowadays we can use the preacher bench to emulate the motion. And he also says that because you're bringing the arm forward, this particular setup adds more resistance to the actual biceps movement. He would perform, now this is the crazy thing, he's basically performing as many reps as possible. He would only start with 10 reps per set. As soon as he performs, for example, 10 reps with his right arm, he would move on to the left and then move to the right again without stopping, performing maybe only 9 reps this time, and then 9 reps on the left, and so on, until he could only perform 1 rep per arm, basically just absolutely frying his biceps and performing as many reps and sets as possible. And that concluded his advanced bicep specialization training program. So I hope you've enjoyed this video on Alan Stephan's advanced bicep specialization program, and I hope that the principles from this advanced program some of you can use, and can tell me all about it if you do use it. I find these principles and methods that have been lost through time really interesting, and that's what I love about reading about these silver era legends. The knowledge that they've left us in these articles and magazines are truly I think worth sharing. So a big thank you to Alan, may you rest in peace. You're a legend. Hope you've enjoyed again watching the video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't to the Golden Era Bookworm. Leave me your comments and thank you for watching. If you'd like to support my work, please donate via PayPal or become a patron at www.patreon.com/Golden Era Bookworm. You can of course purchase many books, courses on the Golden, Silver and Bronze Era of Bodybuilding on my website www.goldenerabookworm.com. That's it for me. This is the Golden Era Bookworm. Bye for now. If you'd like to learn more about Silver Era bodybuilding methods, I have some books online, Strength and Bulk Training for Weightlifters and Bodybuilders and How to Build Bigger Arms, both books by Reg Park, available on www.goldenerabookworm.com.
Hi everybody, I just want to recommend this phenomenal book, Vince's Secret Locker, Volume Number 2 by Carl Coyne. I've been looking at this for about 4 weeks and I can't put it down. If you get a chance, check it out. He also has a part one that I highly recommend also. Vince was the trainer to the stars and had an amazing, interesting gym that today there's still on equipment like it around. It was all made out of wood. He'll be on our radio show coming up probably in the next couple weeks or so. Have a great day, and again, highly recommend this book.